Tensilon test for Myasthenia gravis. Tensilon test is also called as Edrophonium test. This test is used for the diagnosis of the Myasthenia gravis. Myasthenia gravis is an autoimmune disorder. This Myasthenia gravis mainly results in the muscle weakness in the patient. Since it is an autoimmune disorder, muscle weakness observed in the various groups of skeletal muscles at the different organs. For example, it can affect the eye, which may result in the double vision in the patients. And it can affect the skeletal muscles at the larynx, resulting in the slurred speech in the patients. And it can also affect the arms and legs, which may result in the muscle weakness and fatigue mainly observed in the patients. Now, in order to diagnose this Myasthenia gravis, the quick Edrophonium test is used, which is widely known as Tensilon test. So in this video, let us see what is this Tensilon test and how this Edrophonium can be used for this diagnosis and how it is going to be given. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon for getting the notifications on more interesting videos. Tensilon test involves the use of Edrophonium. Quick Edrophonium test is used for the diagnosis of Myasthenia gravis. In this test, Edrophonium injection is given to the patient and the muscle strength in the patient is going to be observed. If the muscle strength is going to be improved, then the muscle weakness is possibly due to the Myasthenia gravis. If the muscle strength is not improved even after the injection of Edrophonium, then the muscle weakness may be due to any other reasons other than the Myasthenia gravis. In this way, Edrophonium injection can quickly diagnose whether the patient is suffering with the Myasthenia gravis or not. Suppose this is a neuromuscular junction and skeletal muscle is equipped with the nicotinic acetylcholine receptors. Now, what happens in the Myasthenia gravis? Because we know Myasthenia gravis is an autoimmune disorder, the Myasthenia gravis can produce the antibodies which can affect the nicotinic acetylcholine receptors. So, few of the antibodies are going to be produced against these receptors, which are going to bind to these receptors, thereby they desensitize these receptors. By action of immune response, few of the nicotinic acetylcholine receptors are lost on the skeletal muscle. Now, in the patient with Myasthenia gravis, if the acetylcholine is released by calcium-mediated exocytosis, then the acetylcholine will have a little chance to bind to the nicotinic acetylcholine receptors as few of the receptors are desensitized because of immune reaction. Now, the acetylcholine can bind to the remaining nicotinic acetylcholine receptors which are present on the skeletal muscle. But at the same time, the action of this acetylcholine is going to be limited by the acetylcholinesterase enzyme which is present within the synaptic cleft. Now this acetylcholinesterase enzyme will cleave the acetylcholine into choline plus acetate, which terminates the action of the acetylcholine. So in a patient with Myasthenia gravis, there is a little chance of binding of acetylcholine to the acetylcholine receptors, thereby muscle strength is going to be decreased, resulting in the muscle weakness in the patient. Now here, when we give the Edrophonium injection, this Edrophonium can inhibit the action of acetylcholinesterase enzyme. Thereby, it can increase the chance of binding of acetylcholine with the nicotinic acetylcholine receptors present at the skeletal muscle. In this way, Edrophonium can improve the muscle strength in the patient by increasing the binding of acetylcholine to the nicotinic acetylcholine receptors. So, if the Edrophonium injection improves the muscle strength, it indicates the muscle weakness is due to the Myasthenia gravis. If the muscle strength is not improved even by injection of the Edrophonium, then the muscle weakness may not be due to the Myasthenia gravis, it may be due to any other reasons. Why Edrophonium is selected for this diagnosis? We know that different types of acetylcholinesterase inhibitors are there, but why only Edrophonium is selected for the diagnosis of the Myasthenia gravis? So many reasons are there for selection of Edrophonium for a diagnosis. And first of all, let us see the structure of Edrophonium. So this is the structure of Edrophonium and we can observe one of the group in the Edrophonium. So this is the quaternary ammonium compound. Because of this group, we can observe a suffix in the name onium. So Edrophonium ends with the onium. Since this quaternary ammonium group is ionic in nature, it cannot cross the blood-brain barrier. So edrophonium can show only peripheral actions with very little central actions. So this is one of the advantages, because edrophonium is used for the diagnosis of the myasthenia gravis, where it should act peripherally to increase the muscle strength. Second advantage is it is short acting. So when this edrophonium injection is given, it can show the onset of action of 10 to 30 seconds. So edrophonium is having the fast onset of action. At the same time, this injection can work for a duration of 10 minutes. So edrophonium is having a short duration of action. That's why edrophonium is perfectly suitable for the diagnosis. At the same time, it is not suitable for the treatment. So within the 10 minutes, it improves the muscle strength, which indicates the possible chance of the myasthenia gravis. Since for diagnosis, we require the improvement of the muscle strength for a short period, edrophonium is an ideal drug for diagnosis of the myasthenia gravis. How it acts? Just we have seen that edrophonium acts on the acetylcholine esterase enzyme. Suppose this is the acetylcholine esterase enzyme. It is having the two important sites. So this is the one of a ester binding site, and second is the cationic binding site. Now this ester binding site is having the serine amino acid, which is having a side chain of OH group, and cationic binding site is having the glutamate amino acid, which is having the carboxylate anion as the side chain. Now we have seen this is the structure of edrophonium. Edrophonium can bind to this cationic binding site by ionic interaction of this quaternary ammonium group with the carboxylate anion of the cationic binding site. And OH group of the edrophonium can form a hydrogen bond with the OH group of the serine residue, thereby blocks the catalytic site of the acetylcholine esterase enzyme. In this way, edrophonium can block the important sites on the acetylcholine esterase enzyme, thereby inhibits its activity. But since the hydrogen bond is a weak bond, edrophonium cannot produce a long-term binding, thereby it can inhibit the enzyme for a short duration of action. Side effects. Edrophonium is indicated for a short duration of action, but this drug should be checked for any possible side effects before going for the test. And this drug can stimulate the cholinergic system, and it can produce any effects that are similar to the actions of the cholinergic system. So it can act on the heart, decrease the rate of the contraction of the heart leading to bradycardia, and it can produce a bronchoconstriction resulting in the difficulty in breathing. It can also decrease the blood pressure leading to hypotension. So any of these side effects are possible with the edrophonium, and before giving the edrophonium injection, these side effects should be checked in the patients. Treatment of overdose. Suppose if accidentally edrophonium is given at a overdose, then we should have an antidote in order to reverse the effects of the edrophonium. Just we have seen that edrophonium is going to increase the acetylcholine levels at the synaptic cleft, so it can increase the cholinergic transmission. So any drug which blocks this cholinergic transmission should be used as an antidote. Atropine is a such type of drug which blocks the cholinergic receptors, thereby prevents the cholinergic transmission. Atropine is a non-selective muscarinic antagonist which can be used as an antidote in case of overdose of the edrophonium. How it is given? As we have seen earlier, the edrophonium should be checked for its possible side effects before going for the real diagnosis. So this test will have the two steps. The first one is the initial safety check, where the edrophonium is given as a 2 mg dose by IV route, and any side effects like the bradycardia, difficulty in breathing and hypotension are checked in the patients. And if these side effects are not observed significantly in the patient, then we can go for the diagnosis step, where the edrophonium is given at a dose of 8 mg by IV route, and the improvement in the muscle strength is going to be checked in the patient. If the muscle strength is going to be improved, then the muscle weakness is due to myasthenia gravis. If muscle strength is not improved even after the injection, the possible reason for the muscle weakness is not because of the myasthenia gravis. In this way, the Tensilon test uses the edrophonium, which diagnoses the myasthenia gravis very quickly within 10 minutes. And edrophonium is a short-acting drug and shows only peripheral action, so that's why it is selected for the diagnosis. And it cannot be used for the treatment because it shows a short duration of action. But under emergency conditions, sometimes edrophonium injection is given in the myasthenia gravis crisis to improve the muscle strength. So that's about the Tensilon test, which is used for the diagnosis of the myasthenia gravis. Thank you for watching this video.